Good morning, everyone. Carahsoft Technology would like to welcome you to our Solix Technologies webcast, 5 Reasons for Government Organizations to Consider Deploying Apache Hadoop. Before we get started, I would like to go over a few housekeeping items. All of your lines have been muted to reduce background noise. We hope you take advantage of the Q&A pod on the left side of your screen to ask questions throughout the presentation. We will do our best to answer all of your questions at the end of the presentation. If for some reason we do not get to your questions, the Carahsoft team will follow up with you offline. To tell you a little bit about Carahsoft, we are a trusted government IT solutions provider delivering software and support solutions to federal, state, and local government agencies. Carahsoft maintains dedicated teams to support sales and marketing for all of its vendors, including SAP, SaaS Solutions, Adobe, Symantec, HP, and VMware. Our contact information will be at the end of the presentation, so please don't hesitate to call or email us for any of your needs. This webcast is being recorded, and a copy of the presentation will be emailed to you. At this time, I would like to introduce our speaker, Vikram Gaitonde, Vice President of Products at Solix Technologies. Vikram, the floor is all yours.
Hey, thank you, Sally. Hey, pretty excited, everybody. Thank you very much for joining the webinar. Sally, the voice is coming in fine?
Fine, Vikram.
Okay, thank you so much. Hey, and thanks, Carahsoft, for organizing this. So my name is Vikram Gaitonde, and I head up the product management team and the innovation team here at Solix Technologies. And the goal today is to talk about Apache Hadoop and how we put it into play. The hope today is to present Solix's perspective on these emerging technologies, and we'll have enough time in the end to do Q&A. So I'm going to keep this to about 30, 35 minutes, keep it exciting, and answer any questions that I can. So the agenda today, what I'd like to do is kind of touch upon what problems we see and how Solix plans to solve it. The reason here is to kind of show you how Apache Hadoop should be the technology of choice to develop these solutions. And finally, I'd like to even show you some of the case studies from our existing customers. So you get a perspective of what the problem we're trying to solve and how customers are actually using it in the field. So Solix has been around for a while. We've been in business since 2002. We have about 150 people, but we feel our strength is in our customers. We have about 2,000 plus customers, and pretty solid technology and OEM partners. We have recently signed up a partnership with Clouder and Hortonworks from a big data standpoint. And companies like Kronos have been OEMing us for a while. And we have a lot of different sales and services partners as well. In the public sector, our customers are, State of Ohio. We got Department of Human Health Services, Center for Medicaid and Medicare Services. And outside of the U.S., we have the U.K. Ministry of Defense as one of our customers. So we've kind of done this for a little bit. Very recently this year, Gartner also positioned us in a pretty elite company. They positioned us as a leader in the Gartner Magic Quadrant. And this was not just because of our growing customer base, but also due to our vision around big data analytics and how we think this market is going to move in the next 3 to 5 years. Okay, so with that, let me just kind of start with a little bit about what opportunities we see in the public sector. I know everybody's probably seen hundreds of infographics and lots of different stats, but I'd like to kind of underscore just two numbers. And these numbers are around the savings and the spend in the public sector. So the study that was done recently, it shows about $500 billion in projected savings just through data analysis. And over $13 billion is going to be spent over in big data technologies like Apache Hadoop and other stuff in the next 5 years. This is all in public sector. But the way I interpret this is that the need for data analysis and the use of Apache Hadoop is pretty well understood. And this is within the public sector. So there are agencies out there already using Apache Hadoop. They are doing very creative things. Some of the areas of focus within the public sector are job creation, natural disasters, and the stuff that I have. I won't read all of those. But anecdotally, one of the public sector companies that we were talking to, they wanted to do something very creative. They wanted to figure out how they could use our platform for public transport and traffic planning. And the urban planning agenda they had was pretty big, but they wanted to use road sensors, GPS data, population data, census data, to kind of figure out how to plan out traffic and plan out public infrastructure. So many companies are already doing it. Many government agencies are doing it. And this is all over the world. So there are lots of opportunities. And as you see this presentation, you might come up with more. Okay. So at a very high level, there are let's start with what problems we see. There are two big problems. Like, rather, I should say the problems are broken into two parts. The first one is the traditional problem that you typically see IT teams solve on the right-hand side, which is of data growth, information security, archiving, retirement, e-discovery, legal holds. These were the problems that IT teams have been solving for a long time. This is squarely in the IT realm. But on the other side, we see a new problem emerging, which again needs to be solved by the IT department, which is how to find and analyze your data corpus for many different reasons. Management wants to do this for either business intelligence, other people want to do it for security intelligence, and so on and so forth. So this has been a new agenda that has been put on the IT team's plate. And more often than not, you are also charged with developing tools, building tools to go mine this information. The problem here is that these infrastructures are created in redundant setups. So you have a different setup for archiving, a whole different setup for data analytics and warehousing, and there's a lot of wasted spend and wasted time around setting these things up or overcoming these challenges. So let me talk about what organizations are doing to address this. So if you see this slide, this is a very typical IT setup. You have a lot of unstructured data sources, you have a lot of structured data sources. And by that I mean, for unstructured, you have SharePoint, file systems, web servers, log files, sensor data, IoT is making a large headway. And in the structured data set, you have your Oracle applications, you've got databases, you may even have a lot of custom applications that have been developed over a period of time. And together, this data is growing by leaps and bounds. You have to address this through archiving, backups, and all these things. So the structured and unstructured data problem has been talked about for many years. You guys already addressed this. But on top, you have these tools that you need to use to, address BI issues or address data visualization. It could be Tableau, Datamere. Most companies already have a setup like this. And what we feel is that, or rather I should say, we see a new blueprint emerging. And this blueprint actually complements this existing infrastructure. And this blueprint spans across all data sources to scale to the enterprise volume. And this blueprint needs to complement the production infrastructure. And it should offer not just reporting and searching tools, but also full ILM capability. And this new blueprint needs to help you address your archiving issue, your backup issue, your data analytics issue, and so forth. And not only should it allow you to move and copy data, but it also should be your data warehouse. It should allow you to do transformations of the data into a single scalable infrastructure that complements the production tier. And what we call this is the new enterprise blueprint. And we've seen this emerging time and again in different shapes and forms. There is one infrastructure that is being stood up, and we see this being done on top of Apache Hadoop. So as part of this presentation, I would like to show you how Solix implements this blueprint and how we are solving this problem. Okay. So This is the Solix Big Data Suite. This is the product that that Solix has recently launched. There are three components to this solution. The first one is, as you can see, we have a repository that is built on top of Apache Hadoop that can ingest structured data as well as unstructured data. So we have a very extensive connector framework that can ingest structured data from, you know, your ERP applications like OEBS, PeopleSoft, Siebel, and also from unstructured data sources like SharePoint, file servers, and this is all integrated into a single UI where you can point and click and move data in. Secondly, this is not just from an archiving or data warehousing purposes. Today, if you know how being used, it is used as just like a swamp. It's not just a purposeful migration of data. What we have built is a very specific application that you can use on top of Apache Hadoop, and that is of enterprise archiving and retirement. So you can use this to retire any ERP data that is over 2 years or any SharePoint data that has not been accessed for over 6 months. And what we see this being used for is, you know, you have SharePoint sites that have grown over a period of time. You can retire your entire SharePoint sites into the enterprise archive. What this also lets you do is have a data lake. There's a lot of confusion around that term, data lake. But really, from our perspective, the data lake houses all information, whether it's streaming data, raw data, or any other data that is not yet ready for archival. And even this could be transient data from your applications or log servers that need to be analyzed. And what the data lake really lets you do is store data as is in a raw format, and then you can transform that in the later down the road. It could be through any custom applications, or it could be through specific applications that you have developed to look at your raw data. And last but not least, if you see on the right-hand side, we have a bunch of out-of-the-box tools for searching, reporting, and full compliance. So what Solix offers is a single UI to do all data management within the big data suite. So you can search everything, you can report everything, but you can extend that into e-discovery. You can apply retention management, you can do legal holds, and so on and so forth. But also, it allows you to use your existing tools that you might have invested in, like, for example, Tableau, Datamere, and so forth. But thirdly, it has the ability to connect to third-party tools for analytics purposes. So if you have storage analytics tools, or sales analytics, marketing analytics, or anything else that you might want to plug in on top of the big data suite, it works out of the box. So we feel that this is the way people will start using Apache Hadoop and putting it into good use, not just to, you know, store data, but be very purposeful about how it gets stored and also how it gets analyzed and mined using tools. And the power of Solix is in an all-in-one friendly user interface where administrators can set up data ingestions and analysts and end users can log in to search and report on it. And again, this allows full role-based security. You log in using your Active Directory credentials. You get to access the stuff that you're supposed to access. Everything gets audited. Everything gets tracked and so forth. So data access is also pretty secure. So let me get into a few of the features of this Solix Big Data Suite, some things that we feel are unique and strongly differentiate us from our competitors. So one of the first things that we thought differentiates us is something we call the Solix Virtual Printer. And what this really does is it allows us to deploy the Solix Big Data Suite as a network printer. And this appears as a network printer within your environment. It's all built on top of Apache Hadoop. It all is on your standard Cloudera or Hortonworks stack, if you will. But what it allows you to do is print any data to the network printer, and everything gets stored as a searchable and reportable PDF document. And this, the application that we feel this is going to really pay off for is when you retire or archive data, you can actually print all the reports from the native applications and store them in the big data suite. So not only are you retiring your data from your original applications, you're also keeping the form and fidelity of the reports in a PDF document. So retrieval becomes very easy. You can have keyword searches to improve your access. You can still do e-discovery, legal hold, and preservation on the data. And we break down the documents into metadata. You can tag it with more data. And all of this can be done automatically. So you can say, we have an application with which you can say every report from this particular application needs to be generated and saved in a PDF document within the Solix Big Data Suite. So this is one clear differentiator. What we also have is, I'll use the example of SharePoint and file share archiving, but the purpose here is to illustrate how easy it is to archive data and access the data. So we've talked about general purpose archiving and retirement, but most of us have file shares and log servers and SharePoint sites that have just exploded over the last 5 years. But most of the data, like 60 to 65% of this information, is stale. Nobody uses it, nobody accesses it. If you take the 6-month horizon, we see almost 70% of the data not being accessed anymore. And that is a great opportunity to archive and move data into a low-cost, scalable storage that, you know, helps you reduce your backup window and improve a lot of IT headaches like performance issues or access issues and so forth. So our Solix SharePoint and file share archiving allows you to just set up simple rules. And rules like move any SharePoint site any SharePoint document that has not been accessed for, say, 6 months, or leave the most 3 recent versions of the SharePoint document and move everything else. Or you can start dumping entire SharePoint sites, for retired projects into the big data suite. But that's just one part of it. This has been solved by many other companies. But we are doing this on Apache Hadoop. And not many companies are actually using Apache Hadoop to do retirement of SharePoints and file shares. The power of this is now you can do searching, reporting using our Solix Search and Analytics tool. This is a simple web-based user-friendly tool that works straight out of the box, and users can log in with their Active Directory credentials or LDAP credentials and start looking at the documents that have been retired. And, it improves the way people access the data. It improves the performance on the SharePoint servers and overall allows you to, be compliant. Okay. And the third differentiator we have is something called the Object Workbench. Now, this has been built on top of the Solix data classification engine. And what we use this for is to identify sensitive data or PII, PCI that might be relevant to many of our customers in the financial services or in the banking sector or in the healthcare services. The idea is to identify the enterprise business record that spans across many different data sources so that you can act on the entire business record as one. So if you see some of the examples, let's say the stock trading example, say a broker gets a call from a client to buy or sell a stock, then the voice data, the transaction, the actual trade that took place, all of them need to be tied together as a single business record. So if there's a legal hold on that document, everything needs to be preserved. So the Solix Object Workbench actually allows you to do that. You can do policy-based classification, and you can tie in structured and unstructured data into a single business record. And again, all this gets stored in the Apache Hadoop repository. You can search and report and analyze all that data. So if you see, what we've done is we've built a multi-purpose repository on Apache Hadoop. It has a clear application in archiving and retirement, but also it has certain key aspects on how this can be more useful from a user perspective, from an end user perspective. And from an administrator standpoint, you still have a very simple integrated UI where you can go and administer the entire Apache Hadoop stack. Okay. So let me touch upon why we actually started using Apache Hadoop and why we gravitated towards Apache Hadoop as the platform of choice. So most of you know what Apache Hadoop is all about. You guys are attending this seminar. But we see this as a highly scalable infrastructure for storage as well as computation. That everybody knows. But, you know, the idea is to give you the ability to use commodity storage or commodity tools. If federal agencies have identified a hardware vendor, they can continue using their vendor of choice. The idea is that there are so many companies that are investing millions of dollars in doing research around Apache Hadoop, like Google and Facebook. The whole industry is going to benefit out of that research. The key, though, is that with Apache Hadoop, you are future-proofing your investments. And if you are investing in any other technology, which you know is not based on emerging technologies like Apache Hadoop, you might actually have to redo this investment in the coming future. That's our strong belief. So let me touch upon the Solix data model. This is kind of the technical slide that I'll use to explain how Solix uses Apache Hadoop. And if there are more questions on this, I'm more than happy to take questions at the end. But what we do is we are using several key components of Apache Hadoop to build our stack. So I'll use this slide to explain how structured data from, let's say, Oracle ERP or any RDBMS gets stored within Apache Hadoop. The two key components that we use are HDFS and Hive over HBase. And if you see structured data, like if you see any ERP system, you have a lot of tables, you have thousands of tables, but you also have blobs and globs and attachments that go along with it. So if you see how we organize the data, the tables are all saved in HBase, and the blobs and globs are stored within HDFS. Now this is not rocket science. This is something that people already do, but the power is that the Solix connectors do it off the bat. So you don't have to do any additional programming. You don't have to do any additional configuration. If you point it to a structured table, we identify the schema, we identify the columns, we map the right columns, and we move the blobs and globs into HDFS. And the reason we do this is because all the structured data as well as the attachments and the blobs get indexed through Solar, and all the tables and metadata are now reportable through Hive. And all of that is available for searching and reporting through our built-in tool. So if you see the way we have done this is as you start ingesting data from structured tables, data goes into the Hive tables and HDFS blocks, but you can apply your custom rules to extract more information from it. You can use our classification engine to identify the sensitive information, for example, documents that have credit cards, documents that have social security numbers, documents that might be pertinent to a patient record, and so forth. This information can be extracted, and all the metadata, all the tags, all the keywords can be now searched through our Solar search engine, through a UI, and also you can report it using Hive query. So if you are good with SQL language, this is a very SQL-like query for people who don't know what Hive does. But really, this is a single integrated stack to get to searching and reporting your structured data. Additionally, for third-party apps, what we allow them to do is if you want to run very specialized tools, that do very specialized analytics, you can apply custom transformations. We have ETL tools that are built in that can do transformations of existing tables. But you can also use our MapReduce framework for very large volumes. What that really means. So from an archiving and retirement standpoint, we need to move the data as is, provide data validations and defensibility of the data so that in the future, for any compliance reasons, you want to prove that the data has not been tampered with, we can prove that through our audit logs. So that data gets stored as raw data in our tables. But for any further analytics, you might want to do summarization of the data, you might want to transform the data into a different view. That can be done for those analytics. And we are built on top of Apache Hadoop, so you can use the heavy-duty MapReduce framework to do that. And lastly, we also have a bunch of different APIs, like web services, JSON, Java. So if tools don't want to go through traditional SQL-like queries through Hive or Impala, they can use the, you know, additional APIs to go and look at the transformations. Now, this probably is, you know, available in Apache Hadoop as is. What we allow you to do is do this through a single unified interface. And that is really the power of Solix. You don't have to do anything beyond just using our UI. From an unstructured data standpoint, again, it's the same approach. But the key difference is, if you think of files or think of documents within SharePoint, these documents have two parts to it. One is the metadata that goes along with the documents and the documents themselves. So what we do is, from an audit and compliance standpoint, the documents are stored as is in the HDFS tier. But the metadata to these documents are now stored in a reportable format within HBase tables. Again, you can still extract all the metadata from these documents and apply custom classification rules on top. But once you start ingesting SharePoint data and file shares, you can start searching the documents for keywords or their facets, like who owned the document, what time was this document last accessed, when was it last modified, and so forth. And this is all through our built-in UI. The rest of it kind of follows the same workflow. We have custom transformations that can be applied. And it makes more sense from an unstructured standpoint, where you may want to analyze certain documents for sentiment analysis, or if you're pulling in Twitter stream or Facebook stream, which is something that we are working on, you can do a lot more sophisticated analytics on top of the unstructured streaming data. Okay. So this is how we actually design the seven node cluster that we are about to see. So this is our starter stack, what we call the Solix Big Data Cluster. We start with seven nodes in the cluster, and we are certified to work on Dell and Cisco right now. And the two distributions that we are supporting currently are Cloudera and Hortonworks. Now, Solix's strategy is to be completely agnostic to the hardware or the distribution. So if you or your client has allegiance to certain specific distributions, like, for example, Cloudera or Pivotal or MapR, every single one of those will be supported in the coming future. And today we are still on a hardware stack. Going ahead, we will support Amazon Web Services and virtual deployment on VMware. So we are going to support practically every style of deployment, every vendor, and every distribution. And this is just a schematic of how we plan to grow our cluster. Again, these things keep evolving as we learn more things and new things get released into the market. Okay, so just the key benefits before I go into the case studies and we'll open up for Q&A. So the key benefits of the Solix Big Data Suite is that it's built on Apache Hadoop. It is built on a highly scalable, low-cost, high-performance stack. It has several deployment options, and it supports many different types of data sources, whether they are structured data, unstructured data. And from a governance standpoint, an ETL standpoint, we have a single unified repository where you can archive and retire applications, and also use the same thing for your data warehousing needs, for your ETL needs, and so forth. And finally, there are a bunch of apps that we plan to ship right out of the box that allow you to manage this information, whether they're searching, reporting, analytics, and so forth. And we will we'll look at a few of those apps that are currently being used by customers. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll touch upon four different case studies of our customers who are actually using the product today. And these four case studies are, four different ways of using the product. And they use our Apache Hadoop stack. And again, these are not the only things that you can do with it, but these are some good projects that will give you some idea of how this product actually works. So the first very interesting project that we see is a very large retail chain that wanted to protect itself from anything that happened to Target stores. Everybody knows that those point of sale devices got hacked and credit cards were stolen and so forth. This chain actually wants to secure their point of sale devices. And what we are doing for these point of sale devices is we are building something called threat intelligence. And we are taking data from over 14,000 devices across 30 states and assimilating everything into our Apache Hadoop repository and building an intelligence to see any patterns where there could be vulnerabilities that have been spotted, or to even predict potential threats, whether it is in a given state, whether it is at a given store, or patterns in days. We have data from many months, and we can identify what is happening in a given let's say for any reason, on a given Friday, they might have a certain specific type of threat that they see across many different states and so forth. So there are many different applications that they are developing on top, but at its core, it takes those Windows registry files from all these point of sale devices, and we are building a predictive model to identify anything that might not be expected. By extension, the same use case can be applied to any company that is using Windows. So any security company or federal agency that is using Windows PCs, the same application can be used to do threat analysis or build threat intelligence for breaches. The next one is a technology company, a large publicly traded company, and obviously given that its key asset is its intellectual property. What we are doing for them is building an analytics tool where they are looking at access logs, network logs, security logs, firewall logs, and all access logs for their data assets, whether it is an internal access or data that is actually leaving their premises. And the goal here is to identify users, groups, or third parties that might be misusing information. And this project is solely around IP protection or data leak prevention. And again, the goal here is to assimilate many months worth of log files into our Apache Hadoop repository and use the out-of-the-box analytics tool to identify any patterns, again, to see what has gone wrong in the past or to predict what's going to happen in the future. The third use case is kind of a traditional use case. This is, again, a company in the Midwest. They are a building supplies distributor. And what they are using our tool for is archiving SharePoint data and retiring a JD Edwards instance. So they are switching from one ERP vendor to another ERP vendor. And this specific example is of JD Edwards. But think of this as any application that is no longer being used by you or your client. And if this application costs you money from your maintenance fees or renewals perspective, it might be better off to just take this data and retire that into the Solix Big Data Suite. Now, not only are you saving cost, but what you get is the ability to now search and report the data in a much more user-friendly way. And that's what this client is doing. They take the SharePoint sites that are no longer being used, all the site collections that are, you know, practically gone stale, and moving that into Apache Hadoop. And then they also take an application that is costing them money year over year and retiring that into Apache Hadoop. So this is a third use case. And the last use case is actually something that we are seeing more and more across the industry. They're using the big data to identify network resource availability. So this is a large museum in the US, and they want to assimilate data from many different network devices and identify events and do event correlation to figure out any device failures or predict any device failures to ensure high availability. So if you see these four different use cases, we can kind of build a pretty large portfolio of different use cases. You have Windows registry analytics, you got traditional SharePoint retirement, you got JD Edwards archiving, you got security analytics, you got network resource analytics, and so forth. And all of that is built on top of the Solix Big Data Suite. And I wanted to start with these case studies to kind of show you why you should use Apache Hadoop. So to answer the question that we started with, what are the top five reasons to deploy Apache Hadoop? You can read them, but really it is pretty self-evident. It gives you an opportunity to reduce your cost on a very scalable infrastructure. Secondly, an archiving and retirement use case are tailor-made for Apache Hadoop. This is, again, a very scalable repository. Archive data grows pretty fast. Archive eligible data grows pretty fast. And there are a lot of applications that need archiving and retirement. Thirdly, the data lake concept. Again, it gets misused, but this is the data that is not archive eligible but needs to be analyzed. It could be your click data, Facebook data, Twitter data if you use. It could be streaming data from your log servers and so forth. All of that needs to be analyzed can be dumped in. Next is the ability to look at any data in a single repository. You don't need a database to go save your structured data and a file share to go save your unstructured data. This is all in one. You can do everything in one single stack. And finally, everything has lifecycle management. Every piece of data, every bit that goes in, will be tied together with our ILM framework. So from a GRC standpoint, from a compliance standpoint, you have the ability to provide your audit trail, your data validation to say everything was protected and validated when it came in, and no eyes saw it that were not supposed to see it. So with that, I will open it up for questions. These are some key differentiators that I have out here. You guys can read them at your leisure, but really everything we touched upon. Again, this is kind of the grand vision that we like to profess. A single repository that looks at all data with a single integrated, seamless, user-friendly UI, and the ability to analyze it through many third-party apps. So with that, what I'll do is I'll open it up for questions, and if anybody has questions, I'll certainly try and answer them. And if we don't have time, we can certainly work through Carasoft and set up a follow-up meeting. Sally?
All right. Thank you, Vikram. So like Vikram said, at this time, if you have any questions, please use the Q&A pod on the left side of your screen, and I'll give everyone a few moments to get those questions typed out. All right, well, it looks like we've had a few questions already come through. The first question is, how do you provide access to the data stored within Apache Hadoop?
So the data that gets stored within Apache Hadoop, as we talked about, there are two parts to it, right? One is the archive, and the second one is the data lake. As we see on the screen, the Solix APM, or Application Portfolio Manager, this has the unified searching and reporting capability. So you don't have to use any third-party tools. There are no applications to be installed on a desktop. This is a web-based UI. You just log into the web-based UI that works right out of the box. You use your Active Directory credentials, so there is no provisioning needed. And depending on the role that has been assigned to you, you can go and search the data, you can report the data, and so forth. So the access to the data is very easy.
All right, another question that just came through. Is this an appliance, and can you support virtual deployment?
Well, we can support virtual deployments in the future. Right now, what we do is we have a hardware stack of 7 nodes. That's the starter cluster. Some customers might extend to 10 or 12 nodes in the cluster. But this is a physical cluster of 7 boxes, 7 or more boxes. In the future, in Q1 or Q2, we will look at virtual deployments and also cloud-based deployments in Amazon Web Services. Some of the customers we have right now also might choose to use their existing vendors like Rackspace, or if they're using Amazon Web Services, we are willing to work with you and understand what the needs are, and we can certainly work with you to do virtual deployments or clouds. But the certified solution will come sometime in Q1.
All right, another question is, what kind of data formats are supported for searches?
The way I interpret this question is, what kind of file formats are supported within Solix, and how can we search the document? So from an unstructured standpoint, the formats refer to the types of documents, like Word documents, Adobe, CAD/CAM files, text files, spreadsheets. So Solix supports practically all those. Anything that you might use today is certainly supported. We have over 100 different document types that we parse and index and let you search. And the UI lets you just search, ingest any of these different document types. Anything that's within SharePoint can be ingested and indexed. Any document that's within file shares can be indexed. So there are over 100 different document types, and if there are certain document types that users are interested in, just please voice out. I'm more than happy to talk about whether or not we specifically support any document type. We haven't seen a problem with that as yet.
All right, another question that came through is, we have a DWH. Why would we need a new enterprise blueprint?
Well, a data warehouse is something that has been in play for a while. People use many different types of data warehousing platforms. What we have is a unique way of doing it on Apache Hadoop. And again, it goes back to the theory that you want one repository for structured and unstructured data, whereas typical data warehouses are only for structured data. Secondly, this is the licensing for any data warehousing tool might be prohibitive in many cases. You might want to do capacity licensing in some cases and so forth. What we are doing is on top of Apache Hadoop, and that allows you to not just have structured data and unstructured data, but very, very large volumes of the same. And that's why we feel that the stack that we have created has an edge over traditional data warehousing tools.
All right, and the last question we had was, what types of applications are supported by Solix?
We talked about this. Let me just kind of scroll back a little bit, one slide. And again, we have, from a structured application standpoint, we support Oracle ERP, we support JD Edwards, PeopleSoft, Siebel, or any custom applications that use RDBMS in the backend. From an unstructured standpoint, we support SharePoint, many different versions of SharePoint, file shares, Unix and Windows. We support ingesting data from log servers, web servers, and so forth. So again, desktops, laptops, we are extending into Facebook and Twitter in the near future. So all these are different data sources and different applications that we ingest data in. Now, the point I'd like to make is that there are connectors out there like Scoop and all these other, Apache open source connectors that can be used to ingest data in. But what you lose there is the context of the application. If you think about what you really need when you ingest this data is to preserve the original application context, and that's what we do. For example, if you want to say, I want to ingest everything from an Oracle ERP, the accounts receivable module, so we can ingest that entire accounts receivable module, and we have the knowledge base that knows which of the 7,000 tables that need to be ingested. You don't have to do anything beyond just using our connector UI. You can just say, get everything from this particular application, and we will ingest it. So that really makes us very application aware, and we can preserve the context.
All right, well, that looks like all the questions that came through. Thank you, everyone. So this concludes the end of our Q&A session. And right now, I'd like to thank all of our participants, as well as Vikram, for being with us today. We hope that this webcast was helpful to you and your organization. And if you have any further questions or would like to request more information, feel free to contact the Carahsoft or Solix team. Our contact information is displayed on your screen, so please don't hesitate to call or email us. Thanks again, and have a great day, everyone.